On June 4, 2020, the George F. L. Childs Airport and the Huonera International Airport reopened primarily to the U.S. market, as other main markets, such as the U.K. and Canada, maintained travel restrictions. Currently, St. Lucia enjoys a 100% recovery rate, but there are fears that the reopening of the borders could see a spike in COVID-19 cases. Tourism Minister Dominic Fedee says St. Lucia must spare no effort and be meticulous in its approach to the phased reopening.
This is not a time for us to open in a manner that is schizophrenic, but in a manner that is very calculated, measured, and very clinical.
The tourism minister was speaking in light of the situation in Antigua and Barbuda after that country recorded a sharp increase in COVID-19 cases since its reopening, including 4 hotel workers. With a population of 96,286 in comparison to St. Lucia's 181,889, earlier Tuesday, Antigua and Barbuda recorded a total of 69 confirmed cases. Out of that, 22 have recovered and 3 have died. This has caused St. Lucia to be extremely cautious about the reopening of its borders. The health and safety of the people, Minister Fedee asserted, remains a priority.
And that's what we've been doing, to make sure that we spare no effort to be meticulous and make sure that we scrutinize every single detail so that we protect the health and safety of the St. Lucian people, their lives and their safety. That comes first.
To date, St. Lucia has recorded 19 confirmed cases, all of whom have recovered. For the DBS News World, I'm Don Nicholas.